I have a confession to make. I haven't been doing everything that I can to really make my SEO, my search engine optimization, great on YouTube because I haven't been putting manual captions in my videos. I've just kind of been letting YouTube generate the automatic captions that YouTube generates. And the reason why that's not a great thing to do is because sometimes YouTube gets it wrong. If you're talking about a specific piece of gear or you're talking about a certain brand or a certain thing in your video, sometimes YouTube will translate that incorrectly. But Adobe just released a new version of Premiere Pro where they drastically upped their captions feature in Premiere Pro. And I'm going to show you two different ways to easily generate and edit automatic captions in Premiere Pro. Let's start off with a fully edited final video in Premiere Pro and see how we can generate captions with that file. I'm just going to click on the captions panel. Now you'll see this new window right here. And the new thing is that you'll see this transcribe sequence button. I'm going to click transcribe sequence and it's automatically set to transcribe the mix. And then you've got all these other options as well. You can pick any language that you want. There's English, the UK version, simplified Chinese, Mandarin, traditional Mandarin, Spanish, German, French, Japanese, Portuguese, Korean, Italian, Russian, and Hindi are the current languages that Adobe Premiere Pro currently supports for its captions feature. I'm English US, so I'm gonna click the English, and I don't need any kind of transcribe into Outpoint or anything like that because I only have this one piece of footage in here. So this is good, let's click transcribe. Now you'll see that it kind of analyzes the footage, creates a transcribe track, and now it's transcribing the sequence. So it actually has to have an internet connection for this, so it's gonna upload to the Adobe server. The Adobe server is going to translate that information and send us back a transcription file that we can edit on this computer. While we're waiting for that, let's play some music. Oh, it's done. All right, so now that the captions are finished, I've got a new window here with all of the words that I said in the video. If I click on a word, it's gonna take me to where I said it in the video, which is really cool. Actually, as you play the video with this window open, it will actually highlight those words as well. Automatically, I can see that it is showing some things that it is kind of unsure on. Whenever you see these red lines in here, it's kind of unsure that you said those things. And right here, I know I didn't go to Bali Beach. Folly Beach is what it was called. So automatically, I know that this word is incorrect and I can click on that and go Folly Beach. And let's play it from right here. So that's just part of the music, so really I don't want that to be said at all. This is a tricky one because I've got music that has lyrics and I've got dialogue in here, so the first thing that was said, it didn't even really pick up. So you do have to watch out for stuff like that. I'm gonna go through the rest of this video and fix all the other mistakes that are in here and just make sure everything is lined up correctly, and we'll be right back. Okay, now that we've got the transcript ready, there is one more step that we have to do, and that is to create captions. And you'll find this convenient button right here that says create captions. When you click it, you'll come to this menu right here. If you're working for an organization that requires a certain type of caption, that's where you'll put the captions here. You could do a subtitle and you can change the styles of those subtitles. Right now, what I want to do is just the industry standard 608 because that's gonna give me closed caption streams. I'll click my first closed caption stream and create. Now, that creates a caption track and it comes up with our time of captions here. So you can see as you go through it, it's timed everything out just perfectly. So in order to export that, I'm gonna click Command M. Now, the only thing that we need to do differently is to go over to the captions menu and select create sidecar file. And in the sidecar file, it gives us a bunch of different options. What we want to use is the SRT file. You can generally use an SRT file when you upload captions to the internet. So that's what I always use. And we don't need video. So I'm gonna click on the video to not export, but you have to export video or audio in this. And we're going to export. There it is. So once we've got our media and our SRT file that we just created, you can throw away the media because all we need is the SRT file. And then you'll need to go to your YouTube Creator Studio on a desktop. I don't believe you can do this mobile, but if you can and you know you can, let me know in the comments because I've never been able to do this before mobile. But you'll go to your desktop version of the Creator Studio and go to the content in there and then find the video that you just made the SRT file for. So from here, I'll go to my details, click into subtitles. Let's go to upload file. With timing, continue. We're just gonna upload that SRT file. And we're done with that one. That's how you create captions when you've got one mixed down audio track. But what if you're working on a project and you've got multiple tracks like music, ambient, sound effects, and dialogue going on all at the same time? It's actually a little bit easier because now all you have to do is instead of using the mix option, select the audio track that your dialogue is located on and then click transcribe. And if you're working with multiple tracks of audio as dialogue in one video, then just make sure that all of your dialogue is selected as dialogue in the essential audio panel. And you can use the audio tagged as dialogue option to just make it super simple. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like and maybe consider subscribing to this channel if you haven't already. We'll see you guys in the next video.